It is a great problem to have when you have multiple trials that are positive with monotherapy as well as chemo and a couple of different chemo regimens, a couple of different immunotherapies. And I think it will be left largely to the judgment of the treating physician and the preferences of the patient, what they will favor. I think that the pembrolizumab is in a good situation of having now data for monotherapy in a broad population of about two-thirds. I think we'll likely be seeing an approval that will make that a broader option as first-line treatment for the patients without a driver mutation. And we'll have carbo and pemetrexed with pembrolizumab, perhaps also with cis, but I don't think that's going to be a particularly attractive choice in the U.S., and we already have carbo-pem-pembro based on the KEYNOTE-21G trial. And now, in squamous, we will have KEYNOTE-407, which is positive for not just response rate, but progression-free and overall survival, and that's with carbo and nab-paclitaxel combined with pembrolizumab. We also have the EMPOWER 131 trial, which is positive for progression-free survival using the same carbo and nab-paclitaxel backbone with atezolizumab.